For the last 3 years, 8 giant drilling machines like this have been excavating the earth to create the tunnels that Crossrail's trains will run through.
Crossrail is a story of huge, huge moments and giant accomplishments.
The new line will run overground from Reading and Heathrow in the west, straight underneath central London. It will plug directly into key mainline train stations, connecting the bustling West End to the historic Square Mile and the thriving East End, before terminating at Abbey Wood and Shenfield in Essex. 120 kilometres of new railway will link to the rest of the tube. Heathrow Airport will be just 26 minutes from London's main shopping district, Oxford Street, a journey that currently takes almost an hour on the tube. It's one of the biggest engineering projects in Europe. Linda's team's first task is to dig out 2 huge 8-story deep holes. These will form the ticket holes for Farringdon Station. Underground, they must widen the freshly dug tunnels to create its platforms, then dig out passageways and escalator shafts to link them to the ticket halls and entrances. Excavating the earth to build the platforms could be treacherous. Geological fault lines run right across the site, and an ancient river once flowed through here, leaving the earth pitted with unstable pockets of sand and water. If the team hit these areas as they dig, the earth could cave in around them, so they must be on guard.
So this is what we've got. Here's a bird's eye view looking down on the station. We're facing the most dangerous type of soil. There's not one, but 3 different fault lines right through the middle of our work. Fault lines present a danger to the long-term durability of the railroad itself. The soil changes, slips quite literally 3 to 5 meters. It provides a pathway where you could have cracks, where you could have future flooding.
The layout of the existing Whitechapel station is so haphazard that it's the only place where London Underground tube trains pass right over the mainline overground trains. Squeezing a conventional station into such a chaotic space is impossible. So engineers must build the new ticket hall inside a unique 180-meter-long floating bridge that passes right over the site. This station bridge will run north to south, connecting down to the Crossrail tunnels, channeling passengers to existing train lines. A skeleton of 6,500 pieces of steel will form its frame. This will allow the station bridge to hang from the surrounding Victorian infrastructure, giving the impression that it floats above Whitechapel. 352 panes of glass will allow light to stream through the structure. Special aluminium roof cladding will absorb train noise, while carbon cleaning sedum plants will top out the elevated concourse, giving this 19th century station a 21st century makeover. To get equipment down underground faster, Linda's team hatches a plan to dig out an emergency 30-meter deep vertical shaft. This will plug into the tunnels below to give workers direct access. Building this shaft won't be easy. Above ground, the site is crowded. The only available space to dig down is on the neighboring tube line platform at Barbican Station. The shaft will sit less than 2 meters away from live tube tracks. The team digging it must remain focused, or they could miss their target, or delay the tube trains that need to pass through this station. One stop west at Farringdon, it's taken Linda and Steve's team 8 weeks to excavate the emergency shaft beneath Barbican Station, giving access to the tunnels below. The Barbican's Concert Hall 1 sits just 17 metres above Crossrail's tunnels. Noise or vibrations from trains could travel through the earth and into the concert hall, disturbing performances. To guard against this, Crossrail engineers have developed ingenious floating tracks, unique concrete slabs of rail and sleepers that sit on special springs. When a train passes over these springs, they should absorb all of the energy and noise before it reaches the concert hall. One stop west at Liverpool Street, Jay Carver's team of archaeologists have hit pay dirt.
It's quite extraordinary, really. We're several metres down from the Liverpool Street pavement. Right below here, we have the surface of a Roman road that would have seen the feet, the hooves, the wheels of Roman carts and traffic. What we've found so far is it's actually a really well-constructed road, perhaps 7 or 8 metres wide in its early phases, and then expanded to about 11 metres wide. Now, that's quite a major highway.
This Roman highway, wider than a dual carriageway, would have helped people take a shortcut across the busy city, just like Crossrail's train line today. Today, they're announcing the new name for the railway line and are hoping for a royal seal of approval.
The Queen visiting the project certainly starts to make the whole project seem that much more real.
I couldn't be happier. We're going to be the Elizabeth Line.
With Elizabeth Line trains due to start running from this station in less than 18 months' time, the pressure is now on to complete the rest of the railway.
God, it's a hell of a